Hi, my name is Jason Rossi, and I'm the promotions coordinator at Radio 92.9. One Republic. They already have like the perfect one-hit wonder band, One Republic. I don't even know what that means, but I've been listening to that band a lot lately, and when you listen to them... Radio business today, it's kind of crazy, because it's all, you know, maybe you listen to the radio, maybe you don't, and maybe you have like the station that you really love, maybe you don't, but for the most part, it seems like the landscape of radio today is all about either you love the radio, or you just kind of use it as, you know, a good friend or a buddy that, you know, you call upon when you need a favor or something. The way inside the industry is, I can give you a little bit of inside look of the radio, is that it's just not the same as it was maybe for your parents or even maybe you when you were a little bit younger. People just don't seem to go to the radio for everything that they used to. There's the internet. So that's why radio stations like Radio 99, we're trying to do so many things online. Like right now we have no jocks. That means there's nobody to tell you stuff about the bands or the music you just heard or upcoming concerts and maybe something of, like that you like and maybe something some of those things you don't. So basically right now the landscape of radio, it just seems like it's coming to this complete... where it's, you have to not only have a great on-air product, but you also have a lot of stuff on the back end, like the internet and stuff on YouTube. So you have to be very interactive. Second most number one hits of all time. All time! No, don't think about Bon Jovi.
Myself personally, I'm a real hungry person.
Like when I get, I'm a real passionate person when it comes to certain things. Like when I get so involved with it that it almost, you know, it probably would make somebody around me sick of me, but I just get so into it. So basically, for me, you know, it took a lot of hunger and it took a lot of, you know, determination to get here, but I also had a lot of people that I looked up to in the industry that made me want to continue to work at it. Like when I was a kid, I used to listen to Sunday morning Top 40 Countdown with Casey Kasem, and the guy was incredible. You listen to him and he'd tell you stories, you really felt connected with him, and I want to do something like that. He was such a great mentor that made me be like, man, this is what I want to be, and I still listen to some of his tapes and what they call breaks. Basically, anytime you hear a jock talk, it's called the break. So I continue to listen to him just to see how he did what he did and how he was so well at it. But there's a lot of people here in this company, Greater Media, that I've looked up to. There was some of our DJs that are no longer with us, his name Dominic Lewis and John Laurenti. These guys that just taught me the ways of how to be successful and how to kind of make things sound natural and not sound like I'm, you know, talking like to an audience, talking to one person. So, you know, basically I just look at the people that taught me things and the people that I look up to and try to hopefully mold that into be something that I can be one day. In radio, there is a lot of, you know, opportunities here. And, you know, I'll just explain some of the stuff with our station being a little limited without jocks, but we have, you know, there's so many positions that you can find your way into. Like, there's a program director, which is the head honcho of a radio station, below, like, VPs and head VPs of the company. But at a personal radio station, you have your program director, you have your music director, or APD, it was assistant program director. You have your promotions director, promotion and marketing director, and you have a promotions coordinator. Sometimes you might also have staff members like, you know, on-air talent as well as producers. Like if you work for a talk station, they have all producers. You know, if you're a fan of, let's say, Howie Carr or maybe Jay Severin, they have producers to make them sound as good as they do over the air. But some radio stations do as well. Like a lot of some of the more popular, like a Kiss 108, they have a morning show producer. And he basically just runs the board, plays the music when it needs to be played, puts up the mics, and, you know, calls the people to listen. As well, you know, if you're a listener, say you've ever called into a radio show, you won't go right to, let's say, Maddie in the Morning or to Lauren and Wally. You go to their producer, and then they'll hook you up through. So there's a lot of different avenues in behind-the-scenes radio, as well as in front of, I guess, in front of the scenes, or the glorious side of radio. So this is just a little bit about the radio business, the way it is today, from someone who's basically only steps ahead of if you were trying to do something like this. So hopefully I give you a little bit of insight. I work for Radio 92.9. Check it out. We just actually debuted a brand new website, you know, some of that stuff like I was talking about earlier, trying to integrate ways to make people recognize us. You see things on the streets. It's a fun industry. I hope you guys enjoyed a little bit of the inside of what I got to told you. Like I said, I'm Jason Rossi from Radio 92.9.